Hi friends, today we'll be talking about the questions asked for the Viva if you are facing for BSc Microbiology for this particular practical, that is detection of amylase producing organism or detection of amylase from a given particular organism or to test that whether a particular organism is amylase positive or negative. So the first question which we may be asked to you is what is the medium used for this particular test? So the most commonly the medium used is what is referred to as the starch agar. It is a common nutrient medium which is supplemented with around 1% of your starch. So common nutrient agar you can say which is supplemented with 1% of starch is the medium used for detecting the presence or absence or production of this particular amylase by the test organism. State some examples of organisms which are producing amylase. One of the very famous examples which you have is various species of your bacillus. You may have bacillus subtilis, bacillus amyloliquefaciens, there are many. You have species like halomonas, you have species like cornibacterium, you have species like chromohalobacterium. These species, they are positive for amylase or they produce this enzyme amylase. There are many fungi which are also known to produce amylase. One of the most common ones, you have your aspergillus. You also have penicillium species which are producing this particular amylase. What is the reagent used to detect this presence of amylase? It is your iodine. The Gram's iodine solution can be used for detecting that whether the given organism is producing amylase or not. As you can see that after inoculation on the starch agar plate and incubation for 24 or 48 hours and pouring this plate with the iodine solution, you can clearly see this zone of hydrolysis. So you can see if you observe this zone of hydrolysis, the organism is positive for amylase, and if there is no zone of hydrolysis, the organism is negative for amylase. Organisms like E. coli, you'll find is negative for this particular amylase. Some people may ask you what is starch. So yes, starch is a homopolymer of what is called as glucose. So it is a glucose polymer, right? You can say it is a polysaccharide which is generally made of two units, right? Two types we say. It is amylose and your amylopectin. So wherever you find only alpha 1,4 linkages between the glucose units, it is the amylose. And where you have 1,4 and 1,6, the branch points there, you have this particular amylopectin. The thing it can be asked that whether this amylase is extracellular or intracellular. So here you can see that the amylase comes out from the bacteria, degrades this particular starch, forms glucose and maltose. Some people may also ask you what is the action of amylase. So it degrades the starch to form glucose, maltose. So these particular things, whatever monosaccharides, disaccharides are formed, they are then absorbed by the cell. So therefore, this enzyme undoubtedly is an extracellular enzyme, which is what you call as degraded or secreted outside the producer organism. What are the uses or which industries you will find the use of this particular amylase? You can find use of this particular amylase in a textile industry, in brewing industry, in confectionaries. You can find the use of this particular amylase also in bakeries, in even in waste handling, right? These particular amylase, it finds wide applications. So stay tuned with us for more such questions. Thank you.